Well, good evening. I hope you're doing well. So, earlier today, Keen Games dropped a new update for Enshrouded, and it's a pretty lengthy one. The very first thing right off the bat, if you don't know this already, she's sitting down. So they have actually had it sitting into the game, so yay. It apparently does not work on all the chairs, but I finally went and found one it worked on, this bench here. Doesn't seem to work on these. Doesn't seem to work on the commander's chair in the bathroom. So, doesn't work on everything yet, but still, it's there, and I'm kind of happy about it. Now, before we get started doing some adventuring, I wanted to take a moment to take a look at these pretty lengthy patch notes, so we're going to do that. Okay, here we are.
Drive-a-bee victim says, "Hi all, I am sitting here beside myself at the fact that there is now a sit command."
Hey, don't make fun of me. I like that. All right, so, Enshrouded Hollow Halls update. It says, "Greetings, Flameborn. Our first update is finally here. Just a few weeks ago, we were releasing our first roadmap, and now we're already ticking a bunch of these boxes. As a team, it feels good. Our goal for each update is to include new content, new features, improvements to existing features, as well as the usual fixes and polish. The biggest part of the update is undoubtedly the Hollow Halls. You can read more about them below, but a word of advice. The encounters will test your mettle, and we strongly recommend preparing well and bringing your best food items, as well as campfires to rest during your exploration. It is possible to run these as a solo player, but it might be a very challenging experience, and we recommend bringing some friends along. If you team up with strangers, remember that you can create a backup of your save files. Of course, since we're in early access, we're very eager to hear your thoughts on the Hollow Halls. Do let us know what you think once you've given them a try. And without further ado..." And they have a video for the Hollow Halls, which we'll look at in a minute. But first, the changelog. And it is huge. So, we have some highlights, quality of life improvements, technical improvements and stability, rendering and performance, gameplay, game world, crafting, building, and terraforming, user interface, and localization. So let's see, what catches our eye? Well, very first thing on highlights. Each biome has a new playable area called the Hollow Halls, with enemies and challenges corresponding to the level of the biome. These daunting new dungeons come with a multitude of new challenges and exciting rewards. New quests leading through the new content. Talk to the alchemist to get started. New enemies await you in the depths. A new survivor can be discovered in the Hollow Halls. Jeez, thank you for putting a new survivor in. Write in content that's going to be super duper challenging and probably can't be done without a couple of people. Unlock a new crafting station with new recipes. New weapons, building blocks, furniture, decorative props, and more can be found. The 60 Hz issue has been solved, providing a smooth experience on higher frame rates. Emily the Farmer now offers potted plants to everyone who wants to add that little extra bit of color to the porch. Make sure that the base has access to a kiln to craft these pots. Ooh, I think we have it. Cade the Carpenter now offers a new set of round doors and windows. Yay, we already have our hobbit doors. The seed bed workstation now allows growing additional tree seeds. Many trees received new growing stages. Huh, interesting. Player characters can now sit on furniture such as chairs, benches, thrones, and toilets. Well, I have to say the toilet didn't work. The town of Willow Crush in the Rebel Woods has been completely reworked, and some other areas have been improved. I don't think I've seen Rebel Woods yet, so I guess I didn't get to see the old version of it. Quality of life. Improved support for stack splitting in the backpack and chest. The size of split stacks can now be selected freely. Thank you so much. Content of magical chests can now be used in crafting stations. Thank you again. The loot menu has been reworked to allow faster and more convenient collection of loot. Yay. Items can now be crafted in stacks. Oh, thank you. thank you very much. Sending items to other players now has a more convenient menu. There is now a warning message if the backpack of the receiver is already full. That's actually pretty handy. A new ping function on the world map allows pointing other players in a multiplayer session to a specific area. I like that. Servers can now be searched and favorited via IP in the server browser. Pretty cool. The keys / buttons for jumping and gliding can now be mapped individually. By default, the gliding is still mapped to the same key button as jumping. If a different key is preferred, we recommend, for example, control on keyboard and B / whatever that button is on controller. Technical improvement. Updating the game on Steam has been reworked to allow faster updates in the future. Previously, every update, no matter how big, resulted in the patching of the computer.
Cabrutus says, "Hi Bella, smiley face."
Hi Cabrutus, how you doing, hon? Now only the affected areas will be patched. Good, because you know, downloading 30 gigs every time you want to update 2 megabytes of information is a pain in the butt.
Cabrutus says, "I'm watching Brazilian match versus Spain and now listening to you."
Well, I appreciate it.
Cabrutus says, "Brazil versus Spain."
Oh? And who's winning? Is that, soccer? Ah, gameplay. So.
Cabrutus says, "Soccer. Yeah. It's 2x2 now."
Ah, so it's tied. I'm assuming you're rooting for Brazil. Alright, what do we have under gameplay? More shields into progression? Multi-shot skill no longer consumes multiple arrows when special arrows are selected. This made the skill too expensive overall. Sorry about all this time spent farming twigs. Update the functionality of the leech stat. E.g. on the Ring of Endless Life, it now has a chance to convert a percentage of the damage dealt to enemies into health for the player. I think I have... Well, I don't have the Ring of Endless Life, but I do have some leech rings. The player skill Bloodletting is no longer triggered by Light Burst and Acid Cone. Fixed an issue that caused too high critical damage for the Acid Cone spell. Okay. So that's a nerf. An incorrect consumption of mana was fixed when using both skills Begone and Sun Aura. Similarly, Begone combined with traps no longer causes mana consumption. Fix an issue with Blood Rage caused by traps. Fixed incorrect application of stun in multiplayer when using the terror skill. The companion created by the necromancer skill now follows the player around more actively. Good. That's going to be useful for me. Fix an issue where the updraft skill could be triggered multiple times per glider flight. You're not supposed to be able to fly forever, no. You're not Jonathan Livingstone Seagull. Oh, that's going to make a few people unhappy because they were using it that way. The skill Breach is no longer triggered with arrows. Healing another player with water aura no longer backfires as damage when the player has Counter-Strike. Oh, That's funny. The skill shell shot now works as described, which we can all agree is probably for the best. I like these developers. They're very humorous. Warden and Tower Aura no longer trigger while the player is down. When successfully overpowering enemies, the Merciless attack can now be triggered faster. Small tweaks to durability of various weapon types. Melee weapons lose durability slightly slower, one slightly faster. Oh my goodness, no. Come on, guys. The ones lose durability fast enough. I mean, that's why I have to have a couple of them on me. Reaching ledges at the intended jump height is slightly more forgiving. Fix an issue where arrow and spell ammunition couldn't be cycled properly when using Q or LT shortcut. Excuse me, hold on a second, I need a drink of water. All right. I feel like I'm reading War and Peace here. Fix an issue where action-borne ammunition selections could skip slots on higher frame rates. Fix an issue where eternal spells could be used up when simultaneously trying to throw explosive powder balls. Fix instances where sound caused by skills or enemies could be heard by everyone in the party regardless of distance. Fix an issue with the sickle's guide that sometimes got stuck in a wall after teleporting. Okay. Loot from flying enemies spawns correctly on the ground now. Was it spawning in the air? Enemies now better find their way through door frames and similar spaces. Oh, good. They've improved the enemy pathing. That means no getting enemies stuck in things so you can fight them easier. Enemies and wildlife now use high resolution grid for pathfinding, improve steering behavior for enemies and wildlife, improve player camera behavior so it behaves less erratic when interacting with enemies. Thank you. I like that. Improved enemy jump behavior. You thought you were safe? Think again. Enemies can now block wand projectiles. Come on, guys. Y'all making being a mage hard here. Wand projectiles no longer auto target bear traps. Using the wand to destroy props is easier now. Before, the homing feature, the wand projectiles didn't work correctly on non-enemy objects. Okay, that's useful. Fix some cases where hitting the head of enemies with arrows resulted in too low damage values. That's helpful. The game now prohibits using the fast travel function while falling. You can't magic your way from gravity. I've never tried that. Darn it. Fixed an issue where interaction prompts were shown even though the interaction wasn't available. Fixed an issue where players could sit and regenerate stamina while falling. I didn't try that either. Improved the jumping behavior while sliding down mud slopes. The player now has stronger forward momentum. Fixed several issues where the glider would be triggered unintentionally when trying to jump. Fixed a glitch that allowed getting catapulted into the air at beds. What? People had. Wait, what? That almost sounds hilarious. I'm sure it wasn't for the player it happened to, but it sounds hilarious. Fixed a glitch where the player could gain altitude by entering and canceling the glider. Not a seagull. Fixed a stamina issue with the hawk boots. The game now should correct numbers when the player gains mana or stamina. Being affected by damage over time doesn't cancel the grappling hook, climbing walls, and that glider anymore. Discrete hits still do. This will come in handy for dungeons, just saying. Oh, good. That means there's grappling, climbing walls, and gliding in the dungeon. Fix several clipping issues for armor pieces. Nice. Salvaging high rarity items in chests now works correctly. So, we don't have too much more, thankfully. For the game world, we have ground fog is no longer appearing in the player base as the area is protected by the flame. Yay. It was kind of weird to have the fog seeping through the edges of your house. Fixed many minor issues with floating objects or other similar visual glitches and points of interest. Darn, I kind of like those. Fixed the incorrect appearance and recipe for dessert flower. Dessert flower? Oh, desert flower. That's right. Dessert has two S's in it. New music playlist for Pike's Mead Reach. New music playlist for Combat and Shroud areas. I thought the playlist was already nice, but okay. Several issues with ambient sounds have been fixed. Fixed an issue with the doors and spires when teleporting away and returning while halfway through the progress. Oh, I guess they don't reset, maybe? Flame shrines now have a small ambient flame to indicate that the flame will regrow over time when the spark has been collected. Okay. Speaking of sparks, need to go gather some. Fixed a quest marker near the southern caravan area that remained as a question mark even after exploring the area. Good, because I keep going back to it thinking I need to see it. Let's see. Crafting, building, and terraforming. I'm kind of tired of reading at this point, so let's see if there's anything worth noting. Visualization of borders works better with combined areas of several flame altars. Okay. Fixed issue that terrain voxel would sometimes become transparent when building too close to the upper limit. Okay. Updated some fireplaces that didn't offer the option for cooking or didn't give warmth. Okay. Another instance of incorrectly saved growth state. Added a quest for spinning wheel to increase visibility of workstation. Okay. Now possible to craft flower soil for Emily. Okay. Improved alignment of several double doors to better fit. That's good. Fixed a rare issue where buildings shapes could be placed in a way that made it impossible to dismantle them as a whole. I wonder if that's what happened with the little scar on my building. No matter. I kind of like it now. Fixed an issue where it was possible to build in margins of certain no build and no save zones. Well, I'm sure people who have tried that and used it are not going to like that. Hard wood is now used in additional recipes. I don't think I've even gotten hard wood yet. Fixed an issue where objects could be dismantled inadvertently through walls while at the same time interfering with seedling placement. Gardening shouldn't be a home wrecker. Allow undo function while building hammer is selected, but building menu is closed. Okay, thank you. Fixed a few instances where no build zones on beds were misaligned. Fixed an issue where terraforming VFX were missing in certain situations. And finally, we have a bunch of stuff for user interface, including character detail screen being updated, reducing the visual clutter of enemy and player health bars, damage numbers on enemies now show closer to the health bar, mana gain is now shown as value similar to health. Good. Fix several typos. Current server load is now correctly showing on dedicated servers. Tweak the custom map marker menu. Fixed an issue with location icons vanishing on world map. Oh, that's good. Fixed cases where drop-down menus would exit the screen if opened too close to the screen border. improved wording of several error messages, disabled the please update graphics card message for older AMD graphics cards, except that when I loaded the game, I got an update graphics card notice, so I guess that didn't quite work. Restored the charging process indicator for staff spells. Fixed an issue for very long passwords in multiplayer. Fixed several items that did not lose the new marker after selecting them. And then they end saying that should be about it. We hope you enjoy the first update. Let us know what you think below. Well, aside for the fact that I hope y'all didn't make the mage weaker, because Lord knows it's not the strongest, although some people claim that it's super OP and needs to be nerfed even more, and I hope not. It seems like most of this stuff's pretty good. But let's take a look at this trailer for Hollow Hall's update.
Enshrouded's first big update is out now. Don't like to read the patch notes? Then let's go over the highlights together and see what's new. Introducing Hollow Halls, a series of unique, massive dungeons, one in each biome. We've heard the community's call for
Kyle Jordan Gaming says,
and with this
what's
new
poppin'?
Update, we're excited to bring it to you.
Hey Kyle, how you doing?
With the introduction of dungeons, we are also expanding our enemy faction, adding new craftable props, exclusive legendary rewards, and
Kyle Jordan Gaming says,
a mysterious crafting
Iowa
station
is Rex.
Recipes, and new quests, one of which leads you to a brand new spooky NPC. But that's not all. We are also removing the 60Hz limitation and updating our camera motion to support higher frame rates and refresh rates. We have also reworked one of our towns, Willowcrush, that you can explore, as well as some of our locations that have been improved and are now more polished. For those enchanted by mystical worlds and cozy underground homes, we've crafted round doors and windows just for you. Get ready to elevate your creations to new heights, or new lows. And wait, there is more. Now you can actually sit down on furniture. Whether you've had a long day and need a break, had an urgent need to isolate yourself and think for a while, or just want to enjoy the view with your friends, the possibilities are endless. Are you a botanist at heart? We've got you covered with potted plants. Simply visit Emily the farm, and once you have crafted a kiln to access various types of leafy friends,
Kyle Jordan Gaming says,
we're expanding the variety of tree seedlings
that look
too,
good.
Available at your seedbed station. Now let's talk about quality of life updates. Our loot UI design has received an overhaul. You are also now able to craft stacks of items instead of having to furiously spam the space button. The gift UI has also been greatly improved for ease of transferring items. Content of magic chests is also now available for workshops. That way, you no longer have to sprint from your chest to the workshop. Want a more in-depth player stats? We've got you covered. Stack splitting has also been enhanced, allowing for more flexibility in splitting stacks. With the new ping function on the world map, multiplayer coordination just got easier. No more shouting at Steve for going in a completely opposite direction. Simply point them to the specific area you want to meet up on the map. And lastly, for those struggling to find friends servers, worry no more. You can now locate servers via IP address, with an added feature to conceal the address for those of you that stream, so that Dark Sasuke will not raid your base while you are out on an adventure. Ha, and you thought that this is it. There is more. Who am I kidding?
These guys
are funny.
If
you're interested in seeing all the fixes and improvements, look out for the patch notes available on Steam, Discord, or our website. And if you want to help us spread the word, comment below with good work, guys. And until then, we will see you in the next one.
All right.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, I am Terminator X9000. All humans will be destroyed. The robot apocalypse is here. Tremble, mortals. Beep boop.
Beep bop boop. I have to say, that's some pretty extensive for the very first patch that they've done. Oh, it's already nighttime. She stood out here waiting patiently for me. All right, let's put her to bed real quick. We would like to go look at the world during the
Kyle day, Jordan please. Gaming says, JK, I'm not a robot.
Oh, but maybe you are. How would we know? Maybe I am. Maybe my cat is. Well, my cat's not a robot, but I'm pretty sure it's planning on taking over the world.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, that's exactly what a robot would say.
Right. So, once again, here's the throne. Unfortunately, it does not have a set function, and neither do these lovely chairs.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, oh, definitely. Cats are devious AF.
Ah, but they're so cute and cuddly. But I can't sit on this bench, so. I should harvest these crops at some point. Oh! And I have a scarecrow. And I guess it's there for decoration.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, dead frame rate though.
What, for me or just in general? Because my frame rate's probably not that great. Hey. Yeah, I know you want to tell me about the Hollow Halls. I'm not interested in the Hollow Halls right now. I am interested in...
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, looks good to me.
Farm soil and honey produce flower soil. Okay.
Come back soon.
Fine, I'll talk to you. What do you want?
Greetings, Flameborn.
Descend into the Hollow Halls. No, I'm not talking to you about the Hollow Halls right now. There's the kiln. Wood acid, tar, and charcoal. You know, I've never even made tar or wood acid. Should probably try to make some of that. What did I need for wood acid? Wood logs and dirt.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, wood acid. LOL with. Kyle Jordan Gaming says, what?
He's gonna pester me until I talk to him about that. Where's my dirt? Oh, that's rubble, not dirt. It's not gonna be in there. Not there. Dirt. Alright, shift. No, shift is quick move. Ah. Oh, that's handy. Use the scroll wheel to just pick what amount you want. I like that. Okay, we'll let that work. I'll go ahead and close the doors. No, I'm not talking to you about the Hollow Halls. Quit shouting at me. He's persistent that I talk to him about those Hollow Halls. I know that there's a new survivor in there. Thanks. But we're not doing the Hollow Halls right now. Alright, let's test out the wand. See how much they've messed with it. Yeah, they did lower the range of it.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, the last survivor?
The last survivor?
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, The last known survivor stalks his prey in the night, and he's watching us all with the eye of the tiger.
Eye of the tiger, huh? Well, I didn't realize this was down here. Oh, there's even a note that I've never seen. The church was destroyed. Curses. Last night, Wynn made a mess of our church, or whatever was left of it. Everett was right. We should have reinforced the roof with some of those building blocks. He'll relish in that, too. Now I must patch the holes, but I can't recall where I had last placed the blocks. I thought I saw them near the church, but I can't find them anywhere. Did my eyes grow tired with age after all? Okay. We got in here.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, yeah, that song sounds way better when Journey sings it. Robot voice, not such a good singer.
That song was a hit back then. I think that thing played at least once a day on the radio.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, classic.
Yeah, let me tell you something. You know you're getting old when the songs you listened to when you were a teenager on the radio that were brand spanking new are now considered classic rock. I'm like listening to the oldies channel and I hear Led Zeppelin and Bon Jovi. I'm like, guys, you didn't have to tell me I was old. I already know that.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, Zep is a timeless classic.
Oh yeah. Alright. We have anything good in here? Oh, we do. There's a chest in here. Ice bolts. I will take those. So this is the lower levels of this town. I always thought there was should have been more to this town. Glad I finally found it. Why it? Oh my god. Thank you for targeting what I was trying to hit, which was the thing
Kyle Jordan
to
Gaming
me.
Says, away, vile insects.
I wouldn't have been a problem except that my wand wanted to target something that was...
Kyle what? Jordan Gaming says, brother, get the flamer, the heavy flamer.
I need to call the Arkan Man is what I need to do. Again? I'll just need to stop that. Anything in here? Nope. Alright, let's head back up, because I'd like to do some more exploring without worrying about whether or not I'm going to become part of the Shroud. The Shroud animation actually looked better. Or is it just me? I'm thinking the Shroud fog actually looks a lot nicer now.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, I estimate a 32% increase in Shroud quality.
Do you? Oh, and yes, that is the necromantic pet that I have a chance of spawning anytime I kill something.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, spooky scary skeletons.
No more spooky scary than the stuff we have to face. Unfortunately, they don't last too long. They do eventually break apart. Oh, did he just shoot like fire out of his eyeballs? Okay. That was handy. But he's gone now. Okay, what's in there?
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, Rip Skellington. You were a good friend.
Yes, he was. Wow, it's dark, pitch dark in here.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, good grief. You just said screw your wall. Kyle Jordan Gaming says, I'm impressed.
Wow. Place is incredibly grim. What it is about games that have post-apocalyptic type themes, but they're always quite interesting. In fact, I'm sitting there I've played Raft, which is kind of a border world style of post-apocalypse. I've played Last Epoch.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, apocalypses are neat.
Yeah, I have to agree. Last Epoch has an area which is pretty much the end of the world for that land. I have this, which is pretty much the medieval version of a post-apocalypse. I could probably keep going, but I can't think of the other couple that I've played off the top of my head. They're fascinating. I think it's just interesting to see how other people view what a post-apocalyptic setting would be like. And this is definitely one of the stranger ones.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, it's pretty funky.
Yeah, it is. I'm not gonna lie about that. It is definitely weird. How many more of these bugs am I gonna run into?
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, George Clinton would approve.
I don't know why that made me think. Of the book Brave New World, but it did. You know what? That would be an absolutely weird one to turn into a game.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, that was Aldous Huxley, I believe.
Yeah. It was.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, wait, no, that's the other one.
No, I'm pretty sure it was Huxley. Brave New World? Because, 1984 was Orwell. Probably be looking for a way out of the shroud at this point. Like, right here? Oh, finally, I can aim wands at the bees. Beehives.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, bees.
Yep, bees. Come on. Oh, come on. Except maybe not that one. Well, fortunately, it's always easy to pull out a bow and take care of these things. And since it looks like I'm gonna need the honey, I'm gonna grab it. Still trying to figure out how you get flower soil with honey.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, if you can bullseye a freaking bee with a longbow, hats off to you. Kyle Jordan Gaming says, that's some Legolas energy.
Hey, wait a second. We were supposed to be making wood acid. Not charcoal. There we go. Well, we got some free charcoal. Forgot, where did I put the charcoal at? And here, where it belongs. You know, I ought to set up a separate box just as a dump box. I actually think I'm gonna do that.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, are you part Sindarin?
You asked if I was a high elf. Not here. In Lotra, maybe. Let's see, shift. Oh no, it's control. All right, let's make a box real quick. What? Oh, I need string. Derp. Manual crafting. String. And of course, I do not have enough plant fiber to make a second one. There we go. Alt. You know, I'm so used to tab opening inventory that it's almost a little annoying that it doesn't here. Shut up. I'm not talking to you about hollow halls right now. There. Drop that junk off. I can sort it later. Nobody needs to see me do that.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, excuse me, high elves are the Vanyar. Sindar are their debased woodland kin.
Ah. You mean the Sindar are the cool guys.
Georg Chris says, good day.
Good evening, Chris. How are you? Hopefully you had a good day. Hey, Cabrutus, how's that game going?
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, I have an unreasonably vast amount of Lord of the Rings trivia in my brain, and I'm not afraid to use it.
Awesome. I have to finish brushing up on it. I've not gotten around to finishing the Silmarillion yet. Okay, what's this? That's new. Interesting. I don't want to break it. It looks like it was an old well. Okay, I can't do it that way either. And probably not the wisest choice to boot. Yeah, let's just stand on top of the old boarded up well and break open the board so I can fall through into who knows where. The yellow ones used to just give resin. Now they give wood and resin too. Kind of liked it better.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, Blind Guardian actually made an awesome concept album based on the Silmarillion.
Nice. I know somebody wrote a song based on Lord of the Rings. I can't remember who it was. I do remember it was, I think it was called Rivendell. Aw, they killed a bunny. I feel bad for the bunny. Bunny, I'm not gonna hurt you. I know, you don't know that. You know, something bigger than you's coming. Run. Random farming plant just hanging out here. Looks like it probably was either corn or wheat. Look at that. That was an impressive place once. Bet you it was a lovely place to live, too. Until people...
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, I just noticed this is a very strange biome.
Oh, in what way? I mean, the whole world's kind of on the strange side.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, well, fair enough, yet. Kyle Jordan Gaming says, what with the fluorescent blue slime and all?
Fluorescent blue slime? You mean the shroud? Yeah, that was definitely a pretty fancy town.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, that too.
Should have probably brought a camping kit with me. Humanity will fade, as all beings do. Their light will flicker and die, untouched by the eternal flame. Meaningless and minuscule in the face of near-endless insight, burning brightly. Turning to dust as we turn to fire, an endless cycle of ruin and turmoil. The ancients definitely didn't think much of the humans. Wanderer's boots. Okay. Sorry, guy. I don't think you need these anymore. But let's see. character. Oh yeah, but the ones I'm wearing have a lot more resistance. But these have 2 stamina regeneration. This has 1 health regeneration. Well, we could see if they're upgradable, and good grief, it gets dark. It's like, it's nighttime.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, whoa, it got dark.
Yeah, it gets dark. It definitely gets dark. Let's see. Put that there.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, son be like it, I'm out.
Right? There we go. And the thing is, if you go out, like, way out in the country where there's very few houses or buildings, that's what night looks like.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, that volume trick lighting, though.
Yeah, they've done a good job with the atmosphere and the lighting in the game, because it really does look good. Too bad she can't just sit on the ground. I can't remember what game it was I was playing, but you could look at the ground and lay down. Oh, Aloft. It was in the Aloft demo. That's another fun game. I'm not sure it qualifies as post-apocalyptic, but it's pretty close. I mean, you find yourself on a floating island.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, Aloft. I know not of this.
Well, it's a game. It's not out yet, but I have played quite a bit of the demo. But you're on a floating island in the air. And there's a bunch of other small floating islands all circling a giant hurricane. And some of those islands are corrupted. And you have to go cleanse them in order to find things like materials for building, recipes to unlock more stuff. It's actually quite interesting.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, creepy.
It is. Except it's also got a really nice low poly aesthetic, almost an, I would say, an Aztec or Incan look to it. I'm actually looking forward to it coming out because I want to see what they do at the full release.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, I don't like hurricanes. We got history.
Oh, trust me, I know a thing or three about hurricanes. I grew up in Hurricane Alley. Grew up in this little state right near the Gulf of Mexico. Might have heard of it. It's called Louisiana.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, Gulf Coast. Kyle Jordan Gaming says, Roll Tide.
All right, let me get a drink of water real quick while we're waiting for the sunrise. All right, much better. But yeah, when I was growing up, we always kept extra food and water and stuff, candles and things you need it in case the power went out during a hurricane, which it did a couple of times. Oh, that's a good way to get her to sit down. Some people are still complaining that our characters kind of look like hobbits because they're short. I mean, I have different complaint. That armor looks like
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, Gulf Coast represent.
Yep. Hey, that's a great place to grow up. That armor looks like she dragged it out of the nearest dump. She made it. I love looking at that tower. That light just seems to go on forever and ever. Yeah, we used to go vacation in Texas a lot. I'm kind of surprised you got a... Did I get a rusted buff here, or I'm just using up the rusted buff I had? You know, I'm not even sure. I'm thinking about it. Well, it's dark. There's a flame shrine. There's a flame shrine. That's a flame sanctum. There's a flame shrine. Need to hit up some of these flame shrines and... see if they have any sparks in them. That's home. There's a flame shrine that way. Oh, maybe I should mark it on the map. Is that a thin ping? That ping's pretty handy.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, that one storm was a bit of a doozy though.
Which one? Andrew?
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, Katrina.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah, that one is pretty bad.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, that was a situation and a half.
Yeah, that one pretty much wrecked a lot of stuff. It took years for some places to recover, and, well, some places never did recover. Out of my way. I'll take your spores. And it's dark again. That means it's almost dawn. So we'll stand here with these lovely fireflies. Yep. Oh wow, look at the sky. There we go. Okay. I'll collect those fireflies now before they go away. What am I collecting? An explosive powder ball?
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, talk about post-apocalyptic stuff. The coast after Katrina was straight up Mad Max stuff.
Oh, I believe it. My parents still live in Louisiana, so I did hear a bit about it. It was definitely not a pretty situation. Okay, so we have one of the three sparks we need. That's a flame sanctum. We even been there? The shroud root. Go to journal. The new arrivals have wasted no time breaking ground, building something. Their determination is fanatical. A flame sanctum. Okay. Alright. I'll bite. Let's see what's going on here. Oh, what's in here? Nothing good. If it's red like that, it means it's insta-death. Oh, maybe I should eat again, huh? What's this? Hold on. Ouch. Take that. Fur patches, huh? Okay. So that's the first time I've seen bats in the game. Cave down here? Doesn't look like there's anything in it but some flint. Okay. Boring. Boring cave is boring. Okay. Really? You're not gonna let me get up there like that. I guess not.
Paint Minis Live says, "Hey there, Ms. Bella."
Hey, Paint. How you doing?
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, "I spent some time around South Mississippi right after the storm. It was intense."
Yeah, I believe it. It did not sound like good times at all.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, "I got TF out quick as I could." Paint Minis Live says, "Doing well, happy I could catch your stream. What came with the update? Anything cool and interesting?"
A whole lot of stuff came with the update. Looks like we got bats now, so we got a new mob type. Probably not the only one.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, "The blue stuff is extra blue."
We got a dungeon called the Hollow Halls. Apparently, the new survivor is within the Hollow Halls, and it is recommended to either be very well stocked before going in, or go in with a party. Waypoint reached. Excuse me, I will take that. That's two of the three sparks we need. "These lovers sought refuge in the flame, but it warms them no longer. Offer its spark at the flame altar in your home. My dearest Helen, please hold your tears and sit by my side. Let us gaze over the valley as we've done before. The setting sun and falling leaves are like our brief and precious time. Let us share these hours before they're swept away by the shroud. Come rest your head on my shoulder, my daffodil. Yours forever, Salim." That's very bittersweet. I mean, on one hand, they at least got to spend their last moments together. But on the other hand, it was their last moments. All right.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, "Whoa. Far out. like a cross between the Dwemer ruins from Elder Scrolls and some Aladdin stuff. Kyle Jordan Gaming says, "Dag. That was depressing."
Well, I mean, if you look around, everywhere you turn, there are dead bodies. The whole place is a little depressing. But yeah, that one was particularly sad. That little bit was meant to get you right in the feels. So, from here, so we got that one. Okay.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, "An excess of dead bodies does tend to kill the mood, yeah."
Let's go ahead and fast travel to our original base, because there is a flame shrine. I know where that is. Well, I mean, it's post-apocalyptic. You think about it.
Paint Minis Live says, "Going into lurk mode for the time being.
All right.
I'm going to listen in while I get a few things done for PML. Enjoy
okay.
Enshrouded, Ms. Bella."
Oh, thank you. And thank you for hanging out. Appreciate it. Yeah, if you think about it, even in Valheim, you find
Paint Minis Live says,
dead bodies.
Always.
Which is kind of funny, because Valheim is technically an afterlife. Fine, I'll take the wooden arrows. I don't need them, but I will take them. Should keep wooden arrows on me for little things. How's my space doing? Not much of it. Alright, let's head over to the other side. Oh, you're still here, huh, buddy? I'll take that. Still got the same old ring. Betcha it is still exactly the same ring. Sigil Ring of the Elder Guard, 8 stamina, 10 health. I've gotten so many of those. I wish, one thing I do wish is that the mobs you kill didn't predictably drop the same exact thing every single time you kill them. This would make a neat little pagoda.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, "Oh. Okay, seeing it on my iPad instead of my little tiny phone screen, yeah, this is definitely not quite unnatural."
Oh no, it's definitely very unnatural. Got an interesting lore behind it. They've done a good job with that. So, we are close to our destination. Is that guy still here? He is. Come here, buddy. I want to talk to you. Nice chat.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says. Oh snap.
I do that to mom.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says. You just ended that man's whole career.
Well, that man isn't a man anymore. Don't forget. These guys are about as twisted as they come. Alright, come on, Fred, number 157.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, join the Dead Body Club.
It's around here. Ah, here it is. What? Nope. Yep. Got it. So we got the extra sparks that we need. There's another good viewpoint.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, let there be fire. Michael Merdig says, hello Bella, looks like they left the smoke machine on and you are getting ready for a concert.
Hello Michael, how are you? I hope you've had a good day. And it definitely looks like they turned on the dry ice machine to 11. But it's looking really good.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, yes, Sabaton about to bust out.
You look way, way, way over in the distance. You can see the cinder vault that she came out of. So that's where she was born. I guess technically that's what it was. She was born. I feel like running all the way back to base to find out if I finally have everything I need for this. So
Kyle Jordan Gaming says,
take the fast way.
Doing your Batman swoopy thing again.
I certainly am. I'm not super duper great at the glider, but I also only have the basic glider. And, well, let's be honest. I'm frankly not very good with it. Yeah. What do y'all want now? Huh? What do y'all want now? I put that in there? Silly. Rusty short sword. Wow, I did just enough fire.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, it's stylish. That's what matters. You pull up to a party like that, you the man.
Okay, I won't argue with that. Now let's see. Hey, show me my bag.
Michael Mertig says, looks like you have to glide. No mounts, correct, Bella?
No mounts. And honestly, I don't know if the game actually needs it, although I've already heard a couple people say they want them. Of course, they did that in... Hey. Oh, now you want something, too. What, dear? Good grief. Alright. 10 wax. Actually, I think I wrote this down somewhere the last time. Wax, salt, spark, shroudwood, flint, charcoal. And the scavenger head. Alright. Let's go gather our materials.
Hey.
Y'all are getting on my last nerve. Hey. Okay, nothing about
Kyle Jordan Gaming says. Dudes pulling up in their limos thinking they cool, then I fly up like Batman and everybody know I'm that dude.
Hey, that was pretty good. Okay, there's the wax, I got the sparks. Flint.
Michael Mertig says, ever played any of the Arkham Batman games, Bella?
No, I haven't. I don't think they would have really been my thing. Although,
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, fun. Yo, the Arkham games were great.
Yeah, I have heard that the Arkham games are great. Alright. Got the flint, got the wax, got the sparks. Shroud wood, charcoal, salt. Okay, there's our shroud wood.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, then they went and made that abomination ugh.
Oh, yeah, the, Kill the Justice League?
Michael Mertig says, Mark Hamill as the Joker is awesome. Kyle Jordan Gaming says, pretty sure SBI had a hand in that one. Kyle Jordan Gaming says, he is.
And yeah, I think you're right about SBI. Did I get everything? I think I'm missing one thing.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, the 90s Batman animated series is GOAT. Michael Mertig says, I saw the Kill the Justice League game, but that is all.
Okay, where did I put this thing? Oh, come on. Where did I put this?
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, just stay away, friend. Trust me. SMH.
Scavenger Matron Head. There it is. Epic. The thing's considered an epic item. Now do I have everything? We can strengthen the flame. Which means now we can also upgrade the altar with 10 shroud cores.
Hey. Aha.
Would you all shut the bleep up? I will get to you when I get to you. Man, I gotta put stuff up anyway. Alright. Fine, we will put some stuff up. Oh, I'm out of space. Alright. Wood goes in here. Not the shroud wood. That wood. Shroud wood goes up in here.
Michael Mertig says, Kevin Conroy at Batman Great Rip, who took his place? Anyone know? Michael Mertig says, as.
You mean for the Arkham game? You talking about the guy that played Batman in the Arkham game?
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, Brother feels rest in power, Batman.
Wasn't that the guy's last role as Batman before he died?
Michael Mertig says, animated series until now, Mark and Kevin for about 30 years.
Oh, you're talking about the show.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, too many legends gone. Toriyama, Kevin Conroy, Carl Weathers. Michael Mertig says, movies as well. Drivaby Victim says, Conroy Batman is peak Batman.
Where did I put the nails at?
Kyle Jordan Gaming says, facts.
What a mess. What an absolute mess.
Michael Mertig says, I think Cavill did Batman's voice since the early 90s? Maybe longer? Michael Mertig says, Kevin.
I vaguely remember the animated series from the 90s. I do remember it was pretty good.
Drivaby Victim says, he voiced Batman for a long, long time.
Well, that's how you know you've got the right person for a role. If they can keep it going for an extended period of time. I hate when I do that. Really hate when I do that.
Michael Mertig says, Mark even played the Joker on the CW Justice League shows. Kyle Jordan Gaming says, oh shee, I didn't realize what time it was. I am so late. Oops. I'd gotta bounce. Take it easy, fam. Kyle Jordan Gaming says, stay based, kings.
Well, thank you for stopping by, Kyle. I really enjoyed the conversation, and I hope you have a great night. Take care.
Kyle Jordan Gaming says. Likewise, Laughing Face.
Don't worry, guys, I am almost done with this, I think. Well, the sorting is... Too bad I can't just, like, throw the stuff and just have it go poof and go into a box. Like the mod that I got for Valheim that does exactly that. It makes putting stuff away so much easier. Where's that go? Nope. Down here. I don't know why I put the wax with the metals. That made no sense. Oh well. We're not gonna worry about that right now. Now, what? What? Yes, I know. I know, dear. You have, flower soil. I'm working on it. It's gonna have to wait, though. I need to make some more...
Don't be a stranger.
...form soil. And you, I am not talking to you about the Hollow Halls. So shut up about the Hollow Halls. Nope. Okay, that goes in here. Got a Gemini ring with an 8% life leech. 1, 2, 3, 4 Segal rings of the guard that are all exactly the same. A ring of endless life with a 6% life leech.
Michael Merdig says, any new characters with the update, Bella?
There is one new survivor. Unfortunately, they do happen to be in the Hollow Halls dungeon. And they've already said it is highly recommended you be very prepared to go in there. And perhaps even take some company with you. So yeah, that's a thing. Didn't I have a chest for... No. No, I'm just gonna shove you in here for now. Because, whatever. Okay. What was that? At least I know where to put the arrows. Get some sleep.
Michael Merdig says, the dungeons sound like they will be a challenge.
Yeah, they did say that if you want to solo them, they will be a great challenge. And they very, very specifically said you want to be well prepared. It does sound like they were made more along the lines of, here's some group content, guys, go enjoy. I decided not to put a door on the bathroom. Why bother, right? Okay, so I need... What do I need again? 10 Shroud cores.
Michael Merdig says, yes, make a hobbit, hud ha ha.
Oh, that's definitely... That's definitely in the plans. Where did I put? Oh, you know what? That's right. Because I've already cooked all the meat. I'll just stick that in there for now. Now, I need 10 of you suckers. Well, what else do I need for this?
Welcome.
Yeah, thank you. But quit telling me about the hollow walls. I don't care right now. I need...
Michael Mirdig says, did they add to the map as well?
Other than the hollow halls? No, I don't think they did. They did do some cleaning up. They made some upgrades to a town in an area I haven't been to yet. They did a lot of... I mean, there is a huge list of patch notes. We did get our hobbit doors and windows. We got a lot of bug fixes, a lot of gameplay adjustments. Shoot, I don't have enough shroud liquid yet. Alright, we need to go play in the shroud. But yeah, they're just a huge amount of stuff. I read it off earlier. It pretty much read like War and Peace. A couple of things I wasn't particularly fond of, like they might have nerfed the wand a little bit. They definitely made the range shorter. And they also improved the enemy pathing, so they will climb now. So there's no going up high and shooting them while they mill about below. They know how to climb. They also know how to jump down from things, too. Which I can't really say is a bad thing. They weren't too particularly intelligent before. Some of those mushrooms. Where did I... Oh, okay, I know where I'm at now. Oh, and yeah, they did add the ability to sit down. Always a good feature to have. I did hear a mob. That's right. He's in the
Michael
dirt.
Mirdig says, do you get any health back when you sit?
I don't think so. At least not that I've noticed. But I was just kind of happy to have that. I mean, you think about it. You see a chair, you want to sit in it. Can we climb this? Yes, we can. Oh, magic spells? I will take those, please. Almost looks like it should have a...
Michael Merdick says, yes, your character will get tired running from bad guys.
Well, yeah, there is a stamina system. Somewhere. Was a section of shroud with a bunch of those mushroom things. Now you're not a mushroom, but we'll go ahead and take care of you. This is where I could use a handy mark something off on the map. This isn't an idiot either. Some nasty mud you were in. This isn't where I want it to go. Although, yeah, I'll take free materials. Not turning them down. That mud's nasty. It just sticks to everything. Sheep. Bye. Yep, bye to you too. I don't know. Maybe one of you can tell me the direction to where I'm going. Obviously, I don't know it. Me while I'm looking at things. Keep forgetting to switch. The wolves are weak to fire.
Michael Merdick says, any new quests or missions? Looks like a good-sized update, Bella.
Oh, it's a huge update. And I imagine there's probably some new stuff, but since I not gotten through even half of the stuff that was already here. It'll all be new to me. Stone. That looked like a log, not stone, but okay, whatever. Maybe if I just follow the road. No, because... Oh, yes. Follow the road, but go this way instead of that way. There was a patch. Of shroud. It was a little patch of shroud, but it had a whole lot of mushrooms, which is what I'm looking for. And if I don't find it soon, I'll just port back to the first house and go down to the shroud there, where I know I can get it.
Michael Mirdig says, Dragon's Dogma seems like it will be a big fun adventure. Enjoying it so far?
Actually, yes, I am. Now, I haven't really played much since the last time I streamed it, which will be, again, this Friday. I'm hoping that Capcom comes through with their first update sooner rather than later, because they have said they're looking into adding a new game button, which that should have been in the base game. I don't know what they were thinking. But yeah, when I left off there, I was trying to figure out how I was going to sleep and if I could use that camp kit I had more than once. I still haven't figured that out yet.
Michael Mirdig says, yes, lots of folks have mentioned the new game option.
Well, I mean, it's just, it's this big glaring hole in the game. You have an RPG, you kind of pretty much expect to be able to save, you do kind of expect to be able to save a game, even if you can't have, like, infinite saves. But you really expect to be able to start a new game if you want to. And the fact that they didn't add that from the get-go is just utterly baffling. Okay, so either they have changed the landscape to a considerable degree more than I thought they did, or I've just completely lost where I found the mushrooms at.
Michael Mirdig says, was that to make it more difficult, you think?
You know, I'm not sure. I don't know if it... I mean, having only one save would probably have just done that. Because it does overwrite anytime something important happens. What's in here? I'm not really sure what not having a new game feature would do. Ew. Okay. I've been here before. I don't remember what for, though. But I remember the walls of skulls. Huh, even the mobs can die to the traps. Interesting. Yeah, that's not creepy at all. I mean, how many hundred skulls are here? Oh, wait a second. I almost missed that. Hunter's bow. Not really anything I want, so I'll leave it there. I'm gonna say, is it dark already? No, I'm just way down in a well. Yeah, I still can't remember what I went in there for. But I know I've been in there. Hello, wolves. Furs, got bones.
Michael Mirdig says, yes, I remember you hoping away from the spiked floors, haha. Michael Mirdig says, jumping.
Take that. Okay, so I really don't have a... Whoa. Never seen you before.
Georg Chris says, mushrooms, you were looking for those and got distracted. Smiley face.
Oh yeah, the shroud mushrooms. Critter parts. At least with the spiders, you get string too. Space do I have above? Okay, I still have space. Okay, that thing's pretty handy. While it survives. Obviously, doesn't survive that long. Okay, yeah. Just a little pit with some flintstone in it. Alright. I'm done looking for this little patch of mushrooms. We're going to do what I originally planned on doing in going back to the first base and going down to the shroud there where I know I can find them. You know, I'm wondering if I shouldn't just break this house down. Bring all the materials to the new house and store them. There we go. I knew I'd find lots of the stuff here. Your spores, thank you. You don't have spores this time, sheep. And I'm not taking that ring again. I have like enough of them to cover one whole hand. I'll take nails. Definitely not turning those down. Take your shroud spores. I was gonna say there's usually a whole bunch of them over here. How many of them do I have now? 21. Not enough. Alright, let's go up. Catch a breath of non-shrouded air. That sound is so creepy. I think it's got to be the creepiest sound in the whole game. It sounds like a very giant creature in distress. I still haven't figured out how to find this hidden treasure in the Braylon Bridge support. I gotta figure that out at some point. That one, I will probably have to look up. Okay, you have a shroud spore.
Georg Chris says, do you know what makes it? That air horn sound?
No clue. But in my imagining of it, to me, like I said, it sounds like a very large animal in a great deal of distress, which makes me wonder if this elixir that everybody was fighting over isn't some creature's blood. And they've been irreparably harming it, not even knowing what it was. How much of it do I have? 50? 58. Do I have enough? Should probably get a few more just to be sure. Oh, hello. Out of the woodwork at me. Shame on you. I was gonna say, I know there was more than one came out of that. Oh, it's night. It's getting on nighttime. It is. All right. Let's go ahead and grab this last bit here. Creatures fighting each other. Because I know I didn't kill any of that. Yet there were three bodies there. You know, that would be interesting.
I mean, Michael Mirdig says,
Wolves hunt.
Almost spring Bella baseball season starts this week. I will be watching your streams while checking scores.
Okay.
Georg Chris says, interesting though. My first instinct when I heard it was to assume it's environmental. A giant creature as the source would be interesting.
It would be. I think it could add some very interesting context to what the elixir is and why the world became so corrupted as a result of its overuse.
Michael Mirdig says, yes, a troll who is hungry. Ha ha.
Boy, that would be one big troll. I don't even think a 4-star troll in Valheim would be that big. Maybe it's not even that serious. Maybe it's just the voice of the ancients from beyond wherever they've gone. Who knows? It is a creepy sound, though. Alright. I think we might have enough now. So, let's go ahead and head back home.
Hey!
Would you hush? Hush, hush! Put that up. Got a metric ton of stuff. Again.
Michael Mirdig says, Ugloth was a large skeleton. Got to watch one battle against him. Michael Mirdig says, Yagloth.
Yagloth, yeah. Yagloth was a challenge. But it was a lot of fun too. And I will say that the music that they played during the Yagloth battle was pretty epic.
Michael Mirdig says, Meteor attack was wild.
Yeah, it was. Nope, down here. Put the metals down here. No, not the bow. And where did the bow go? I don't know. Oh, right here. That's what I wanted to put away. Right there. And the nail. Alright, enough playing around. You! No, I don't want to talk about the Hollow Hall.
Fire burns still.
Yes, it does. Now, can you make me 10 of these? Shift and space, craft 10. Thank you very much for that.
It's still magic, even if you know.
Yeah, they added the ability to split stacks better. They added the ability to craft multiple items at once. They added some nice quality of life additions to the game. So, that was huge. Alright. Upgrade the altar. Now, it is at max. We have strengthened the flame, which means we can last 7 minutes in the shroud by default instead of 6. Let's see how far this took us this time. Oh wow, how far does this go? Okay. Usually I see the... all the way out here.
Michael Mirdig says, I want to try Zoria. It is a smaller turn-based RPG. Has a D&D feel to it.
Almost the whole field. But yeah, look at how far out this went. Even goes out. To the very edge of this. Holy smokes. So we have all of this in here we can build. And if I move the flame altar from where it's at, more to over here by the bridge, we could get out even further. Because right now, part of what this covers is way up in that cliff there. And I think it even goes down towards the shroud now. Yeah, there's the line.
Michael Merdig says, Bella, I have never used Steam. Are all the larger games or more expensive games available on it?
All of them? I don't know about all of them. But there are a number of... I mean, there's lots and lots of games on Steam. I mean, name something, I'll see if I recall seeing it. Put that stuff away. Get some rest, little girl. Oh. Well, that would be the usual place a person would go first thing in the morning. I'll listen to you prattle on about it. Tell me about it.
Hello there.
Hello. By now you've encountered the Hollow, skeletal husks animated by ire and the curse of the flame. Legends say they were banished into grand underground halls of unknown origin. I discovered one such hall during my studies, but I could not enter. Maybe you can. Best assemble a team if you have one to descend.
Fascinating, isn't it?
Fascinating, I guess. So where is this, mythical... I see, that's obelisk. Oswald's chest. Ruined Netherthun. Okay, where is it? Explore the Hollow Halls. Oh, we were near that earlier. Because I went and got that, the core from that flame shrine. So that's what that is. I was wondering... Good thing I didn't go in, because I know I am certainly far from prepared. At least now we know where it's at. Thanks.
Hey!
Hello, what do you want?
Oh, let's plant a seed!
Beware the Hollow. My dear, the alchemist asked you to enter the Hollow Halls. Beware the Hollow inside. These thieves conspired to claim part of the flame and were cursed by the ancients as punishment. To never feel the warmth of another, I almost pity them.
Bless the ancients.
That would be one. That would be quite the curse, no lie. All right, let me guess. You wanna talk to me about it too?
I can do it.
Why? Why did I guess?
Ha!
So the ghastly catacombs that house the Hollow are real. My Aunt Ellen used to tell stories. But, well, you know her. Always a telltale, that one. If old Balthazar has seen them himself, then it's true. Oh, think of the materials, the architecture, the treasures. I wish my little legs could take me there, too. No, you don't. Trust me, no, you don't. But while we're here, advanced glider, we need to find shroud sacks. I don't even know what that is, but I guess I'm gonna learn. Shroud core, shroud liquid, shroud spores, grappling hook. Except I think I already have an improved grappling hook. So I don't worry about that. We have that. We have, actually, I thought there was an improved one of those. Maybe that is the improved one. I'll check later. Chairs, benches, the bathroom items, all the lights. That chandelier's kind of neat. So are the brassieres. There's a rough one, and there's a more polished one. I'll probably have to make a couple of those. Oh! New doors. Those look nice. A little too fancy for her house, but they would fit on the house I'm hoping to fix. Ah! Oh, look at those. Wait a second. But no hobbit doors. Hey, you gave me the windows, but not the doors. What gives? I'm disappointed. And of course, secret doors. Secret stone door. Secret wood door. Secret stone floor passage. Secret wood floor passage. Which I honestly, I didn't think they were going to actually let us build those. I just thought they were fun to find in the world. So, yeah, to recap, they've done a lot of updates. With the update. Words. I swear I know how to not to double use them. But, so far, I was worried for nothing about the wand. They seem to be still pretty okay. Even if I do have to get a little closer to kill stuff with them. The graphics do look like they're improved. The Hollow Halls sound like they will be fun, but not until I'm actually ready for them. And pretty much everything they did only made me more excited for what they'll do in the future with the game. Ha! Die. Bugs. Wonder if I'm gonna be able to make that as a decoration. I hope so. Be nice to put a stove in the house. Yeah. I'd say I'm pretty happy with how the update came out.
Michael Merdig says, I have seen some sim build battle survival games lately. New cycle, a King Arthur medieval and a Dwarven Underground style are interesting. Do you like these types of games? Michael Mertig says. Yes, I like this game, Bella.
Let's see. Let me get out of the shroud first. So I can actually read that without getting myself killed. Oh, yeah. I'd like to be able to make this wrought iron fence, too. That would be nice. Always looking at architectural details I could add to my base. Alright, so we're out of the shroud. Sim build battle survival games. That I have not seen. A King Arthur medieval game. Now, a King Arthur medieval game sounds interesting. That I would like to see what they do with that. And a dwarven underground style. You mean like Return to Moria? There was a game demo I tried last year. It was another dwarven game. It was called Return to Nangrim. But it seems to have disappeared from the store, which is very sad. But it definitely looked like it had promise. But hold on a second. Let's go ahead and oh no, there it is. Return to Nangrim. So, unfortunately, it does not have any sort of release date. Just says coming soon, and it does seem like it's been coming soon for a while. Like I said, I tried out the demo.
Michael Mertig says, you build, train troops, battle in real time, grow crops, attain water, produce supplies, everything you would do in that world. Cool and interesting.
Okay, so it's kind of like, okay, I see what you're saying. That's an awful lot going on for that.
Michael Mertig says, like SimCity in a way.
Yeah. Actually, I have a game that is coming to quarter two's Let's Play that sounds like it's similar in a way. But yeah, this game here says Return to Nangrim is a dark first-person fantasy adventure with survival and RPG elements. Embedded in an epic dwarven lore, craft, explore, and survive an abandoned and hostile world. So grab your axe and shield and go on an epic journey that will take you and your animal companion into the ominous depths of an ancient mountain. And like I said, the demo seems to have disappeared, which is too bad, because it was rather interesting what I saw of it. I wonder what the trailer looks like. I guess we can look. Little laggy. Sorry about that. I don't know why. Yeah, I got as far as trying out the crafting on it, which is a little more involved than most games. And yes, it has spiders, because, you know, every survival RPG has those. SyncoForge.com. I think the closed beta is over. But yeah, that. I'm hoping they do something with this one. Because, in a way, that kind of reminds me a little. Well.
Michael Merdig says, yes, shout out to Shalab and Ungoliant.
Right? It reminds me of Tolkien dwarves. And I'm wondering if they didn't maybe get in trouble for that. So, the game that I'm going to be playing for quarter two's Let's Play was given to me by Gus, and it's called Against the Storm. It says it's a dark fantasy city builder where you must rebuild civilization in the face of apocalyptic rains. As the Queen's Viceroy, lead humans, beavers, lizards, foxes, and harpies to reclaim the wilderness and secure a future for civilization's last survivors. So, you've got your city building, you've got your crafting, you've got your gathering, you've got all this management stuff, which is very similar to what you were talking about, because you're building. You're controlling groups of people that come and join your village. And it's actually pretty interesting game. Anybody want to see the trailer for it?
Michael Merdig says, yes, that looks fun. This is like what I was talking about. Michael Merdig says, talking.
Okay. Let's go ahead and we'll look at the 1.0 release date trailer.
Georg Chris says, sure, trailer. Michael Merdig says, new cycle I think is a more expensive game that is like this Bella?
I'd have to look it up.
Michael Merdig says, I like the animation here.
Yeah, it's pretty interesting. I've been playing with the tutorial, and it looks deceptively simple, but it's pretty complex. And like they said, each run is very different. You're not going to get the same materials. You're not going to get the same upgrades each time. It's pretty unique. Looking forward to that. And what is this one? News cycle, you said? Let's look that up. News cycle. Alright, New Cycle is a city-building game with focus on survival. After an apocalyptic series of solar flares, human society has been thrown into disarray. Establish a settlement and develop it all the way from humble beginnings to industrial metropolis. Okay, let's check out the trailer. General cinematic. Alright. Whoa, 5 minutes? Hold on. But this is only 30 seconds. Really? You're gonna give me 5 minutes or 30 seconds? That's it. You know what this reminds me a little bit of? Frostpunk. This reminds me a little bit of Frostpunk. I'll put it on my wish list. I'll keep an eye on it. See how it goes. There's also Surviving Mars, which is another game I have, which I haven't played much of yet, but it looks interesting. There was another similar game to this that I have. I can't remember the name of it right now. But yeah, it depends. But I do sometimes like games like that, yes. Alright, so... Oh, shoot. It's gotten late on me. I should probably end because, well, as usual, I have not eaten supper yet. And I'd like to do that. I'd like to eat supper before...
Michael Mirdick says, the medieval game with a King Arthur feel real-time battle looks fun, but do not remember what it was called, Bella.
Well, if you do remember, let me know in either the comments of a video or a future stream, and I will look it up too and see, because King Arthur was a personal favorite of mine when I was a kid. That might be something worth keeping an eye on too. And thank you for letting me know about these. I do appreciate it. Like I was saying,
Michael Mirdig says, I enjoy the Knights of the Round Table story.
I do too. And I'll admit, it probably was some Disney-esque cartoon when I was a kid that got me into it. But still, it worked, right? Oh yeah, maybe it was Sword in the Stone. Well, I do want to thank everybody for stopping by. I really enjoyed the conversation. It was great. I appreciate the support, the views, all that fun stuff. And hey, if you're new and you don't want to miss a video or a live stream, well, considering hitting that subscribe button. and ring that bell.
Michael Merdick says, fun again, Bella, until next time.
So, thank you again, everyone. Thank you, Michael. And until next time, bye for now.
Georg Chris says, goodbye.
And take care, Chris.